you like him?
Oh, he's going to dump me. I know it. Now, why did I choose to have rejection so early in the morning?
You don't know that that's going to happen. Things could work out.
Hi.
Hi.
Hey, yeah, better get off to work now.
See ya. Thanks for texting me back last night. I didn't know whether I should call you or not.
Yeah, I'm sorry I haven't been in touch. I've been kind of busy with work.
That's okay. You're probably trying to get your head around everything that's going on with me. And I don't blame you. I just don't want to know where we stand.
Well, it did kind of mess with me that you're giving up your baby.
Well, you're here. So that means something, right?
Dex! Can I talk to you for a second?
I'm already a bit late.
Yeah, it's fine, Jacqueline. Is there anything going on with April that I should know about?
No, nothing I can think of.
You were in Mr. Murphy's class yesterday?
Okay, I admit the thing with the pens was a little bit weird, but Jace was being a jerk towards her.
Right, so nothing else going on.
What do you mean?
Yeah, you're right. Look, I'm sorry, I shouldn't put you on the spot like this. It's rude of me.
It's okay. To be honest, she has been pretty stressed out lately, but I don't think it's about anything in particular.
Okay. Thanks.
My head.
You are so hungover.
And you're not?
I feel fantastic.
What's wrong with you?
A certain person can't handle his liquor. Oh. Anyway, look, I have to go. I've got to chase up some surf club sponsors. I'll see you later.
See
you.
You sly old bugger.
She's my flatmate.
Oh.
Oh, what?
Oh, I just didn't think you'd find someone so quick, that's all.
Well, and you and Bianca now interested?
Actually, just me. Oh, Bianca's decided to move in with Irene. April's got this thing going on. We just thought it'd be the best thing to do.
Well, it's just you. There's plenty of room. As long as you don't mind, Rue is a flatmate.
Should I be worried?
So the thing is, I've been doing some research about how you can make it work. Now, you can go to the Centrelink website and check out for yourself if you like, because if you do want to keep this baby, then there are allowances that you can apply for.
Angus.
And there's a creche at the uni, the subsidised rates if you're a student. And look, I know for the first year or so, you might want to go part-time.
It's really not about the money. Look, it's really sweet that you've done all of this research. But I'm not ready to be a mother. I don't want this baby. End of story.
Hey, how's it going?
Not great. I think he wanted to be my salvation.
Oh, he thought he'd at least try. He's probably punching the air with relief right now.
I think so.
Ready to go?
Angus, I'm really sorry. I should have been more upfront with you from the start.
No, I'm the one who should be sorry. I got the wrong idea. And you know, all that stuff about the allowances and everything, I guess I was just trying to help.
No, it's okay. I think that things are a little bit more complicated than you realize.
Yeah, I get that now.
So what does that mean for us? I guess I just want to know where we stand, because I really do love spending time with you and I'd like to do it some more.
I think I need some time to get my head around everything.
Okay.
Let's go for a walk. We'll talk some more. We'll take it from there.
Okay, April. Got your pathology results here from the biopsy we did. And, yeah, dysplastic knee.
Oh, it's bad. I knew it.
No, it's good. It means the mole's completely harmless.
Are you serious?
I don't joke about diagnosis. Patients wouldn't appreciate it, I don't think.
I was so sure it was going to be bad news.
You've really got yourself worked up about this, haven't you?
No, I'm just stressed out at the moment.
Tell me, have you had any more of those shortness of breath episodes?
No.
But you're generally feeling anxious, aren't you?
I'm fine, really. Are we done here?
Look, April, whilst you're here, I want to talk to you about some relaxation techniques. Please, have a seat.
No, wait, has Bianca been talking to you?
No. Should she have?
No,
Well, she thinks I'm stressed out, that's all. But what year 12 student isn't?
Yes, yes. I'm sure you're not alone there. I mean, year 12's a pretty tough time.
Mate, I've got to admit just how good a hot shower really is.
Oh, hello.
Oh, hey.
What are you doing half naked in my house?
This is actually my house too.
Yeah, Liam has moved into the third bedroom. Hope you don't mind.
Well, I really wanted someone good looking, you know. What am I going to do with you two guys hanging around all the time?
Sorry?
Nah, nothing. Nothing at all. I move over. No. Hey, can you open that for me?
Yeah, but I...
Thank you. Have you drunk out of that?
No.
Shh. Oh, I'm so sorry that we're late.
It was my fault. I was trying to convince Nicole to take the menswear elective next semester. It was the only way I was going to get decent clothes while still at uni. So.
Well, never mind. There's still plenty of time to get to the class. Unless you want Angus to go with you.
Oh, no, it's okay. He just drove me here.
But I don't mind if you prefer Angus to go with you. It's just a little bit of notice.
It's okay.
Seriously, I'm not here to get in the way. I'd better go.
Oh, I'll walk you out. I'm really sorry about Marilyn. She gets a little bit possessive. I guess she just wants to spend as much time as she can with the baby. And I mean, I do understand that, all things considered.
I don't think I can do this.
Sorry?
I thought I could make myself be okay with it all, but this situation, it's just... I don't know, it's just messed up on so many levels. Nick, I'm sorry. I don't think we should see each other anymore.
But you said to me that you would give it time.
Yeah, I don't need to. I know how I feel, and I'd be lying to us both if I pretend anything else. And, you know, in all honesty, I know it's going to end badly. There's no way that it can't. Honestly
thought that we had a connection. And, you know, for the first time in ages, I felt like I was going to have a life after being pregnant.
Look, if he's not mature enough to deal with the situation now, it's better that you know.
Yeah, I guess.
Nick, all these things happen for a reason. And at least now you'll be able to focus on the rest of the pregnancy without any distractions.
And that works for you, doesn't it?
I'm sorry?
But this is what you have wanted all along. For Angus to be out of the picture.
No, it isn't.
No, I know you care about the baby, but you need to stop controlling my life.
Nicole, I care about you.
You care about the baby.
Of course I care about
the
baby.
I'll leave you to it.
She's blaming me for that Angus boy leaving.
Yes, I heard. You know, I wouldn't blame her if she walked away from this arrangement.
Bianca spoke to me today.
Well, what did you tell her?
Look, there's nothing to tell. I don't know what's going on with you.
Okay, well, I was in seeing your dad earlier about Mole, and he thinks I should try some relaxation techniques for my anxiety. Don't really think it's gonna work, though.
Did you tell him what happened at school, about the pens, how you freaked out?
See, the thing is, it's not about trying to relax. I have to keep things in perfect order or else... I just do, okay?
What do you mean?
I mean that if I don't, then terrible things will happen.
Sounds like superstition, like not walking on cracks in the
floor. When Liam took my pen, I knew that something bad was going to happen. Dex, I could feel it. And then Bianca had that electric shock. What?
I'm just trying to see how those two things could possibly go together.
Okay, well, that's what I'm trying to tell you. If I don't keep things in perfect order, then more bad things will happen. That's just how it is.
Try the meditation. Dad's the last person to suggest anything alternative unless he thought it would really work.
Okay.
Next time on Home and Away.
So what's the deal with you and Ruby anyway?
I've been hanging out a bit.
She seems pretty messed up right now. You sure you want to get into that?
I just don't feel right about her and Casey. Every instinct I've got is telling me that it's a mistake.
Back off. I'm capable of making my own decisions.
Right, because your decision to sleep with Romeo was such a great one.
You think that I can't see what you're trying to do? You're mistaken.
Frankly, it sounds to me like you've got every reason to be upset.
You should be ashamed of yourself, Marilyn.
Nicole and I have an agreement.
It doesn't give you the right to intrude on her life. She has to be able to make these decisions without the pressure from other people.
Catch up on what's happening on Home and Away online at Yahoo 7 TV.